by far the best investment you can make is in yourself. I mean, that, for example, communication skills. I tell the students that come that they're going to graduate schools and business, and they're learning all these complicated formulas and all that. If they just learn to communicate better, and both in writing and in person, they increase their value at least 50%. If you invest in yourself, nobody can take it away from you. If I gave you a car, and it'll be the only car you get in the rest of your life, you'd take care of it like you can't believe. Any scratch you'd fix that moment, you'd read the owner's manual, you'd keep a garage and do all these things. And you get exactly one mind and one body in this world. And you can't start taking care of it when you're 50. By that time, you'll have rusted out if you haven't done anything. So you should really make sure that you just remember that you just got one mind and body to get through life with and to do the most with it.
What about life advice?
Well, life advice is, the most important thing is really who you associate with. You want to associate with people that are better than you are. I mean, basically, you'll go in the direction of the people that you associate with. And you want to have the right heroes. You want people, if you want to emulate somebody, you better pick very carefully who you want to emulate. And obviously, you can't pick your parents. They're going to have an enormous influence on you, but you don't get a choice on that. But you get choices as you go down the line. And who you admire, who you want to copy. And the most important for most people in terms of that decision is their spouse. It's also important in terms of a partner in business, but the partner in life is the most important one. You want to pick a spouse that's better than you are.
Biggest mistakes people make when investing?
Well, they just don't realize that all you have to do is just buy a cross section of America and then never listen to people like me or read the papers or do anything subsequently. They think that because you can trade, you should trade. You buy a farm, you buy an apartment house, you can't resell it tomorrow. And the cost of moving around. Now you get something handed to you, liquidity, which is instant. You can sell, and the cost of doing it are pennies, compared to other kinds of investment activity. So because they can so easily move around, they do move around. And moving around is not smarter than investing.
You have a pretty cool morning routine regarding what you have for breakfast and how prosperous you feel. What is that?
I eat exactly what I like to eat. If somebody offered me a deal when I was 20 and said, you're going to live 1 year longer, instead of living to 88, you'll live to 89 or whatever it may be, if you eat nothing but broccoli and Brussels sprouts and onions and all these things, I just said, I'll take the last year off. It probably won't be that good anyway. So I eat exactly what I like to eat.
Is business school worth it?
Depends on the person, much more than it depends on the school. I mean, I wouldn't worry. Some people are going to get a lot out of advanced education, and some people are going to get very little. And I don't even think it's important that every person go to college at all. I mean, we have all kinds of jobs that 70 or so thousand a year, 80,000 a year, that college training is not of use. And I actually was not keen on going to college.
Really?
Myself. Yeah, my dad kind of jollied me into it. He could get me to do anything. But I knew I could have a good time, and I liked investing, and I didn't really feel I could read the books. It's a big commitment to take 4 years, and the cost involved, and maybe the loans involved and everything. And I think, depending on what your interests are in life, I don't think it's for everybody. I think it's for a lot of people. But there ought to be a reason you're going. And I didn't really see much reason. If you get to be 65 or 70 and later, and the people that you want to have love you actually do love you, you're a success. I've never seen anybody that reaches that age. I mean, I'm not talking about somebody that's in extreme poverty or pain or something, but I've never seen anybody that, if they have a lot of people that love them, that is other than happy. And I've seen some very, very wealthy people that they give testimonial dinners to and name schools after and everything. And nobody loves them. Yeah. By far the best investment you can make is in yourself. If you invest in yourself, nobody can take it away from you.